was a boy from the mid-Atlantic, fast as hell. Had a 4-second 40 that he never had to work for. Lacrosse in the spring, track in the winter. But football was the sport that had all the scouts watching. Got a full ride to Alabama senior year. Then he took a big hit and watched it disappear. Oxycontin was prescribed till the pain subsides. But he took him long after for the pain inside. His dad worked a lot so he was never at home. And mom drank a lot cause she was always alone. So neither one noticed their son's aura of gloom, brought on by crushing up pills and blowing lines in his room in suburbia. Oh, they're living the American dream out in suburbia. Oh, it ain't exactly what it seems. He kept it on the low for a couple of months, still chilled with the boys joking and smoking blunts. But the monkey was on his back, never was far from his oxy sack. He started acting out and he developed a twitch. He started treating all his friends like a son of a bitch. See, the problem was his high was getting kinda dull, and he had the biggest milligram that was available. It wasn't enough. At the end of his rope, his dealer gave him a stamp bag of dope and said, "Don't be scared, son, everybody knows it ain't that bad for you, long as it's going up your nose in suburbia." Oh, they're living the American dream out in suburbia. Oh, it ain't exactly what it seems. On his 18th birthday, he was out on the streets, West Baltimore, where Lombard and Payson meet. A hunger in his eyes, looking to score a balloon with some cash made pawning family heirlooms. He had started shooting up only a couple months back, got his last hat trick from inside a rehab. A skeleton filled with a permanent lean, he dropped 25 pounds and still swore he was clean. The story ain't unique, it's a global epidemic. Opioids reprinted medicine by chemists. The system is broken, it ain't getting fixing, cause big pharmaceuticals have monetized addiction in suburbia.